Hi, welcome to GRAGHICS Engineers Academy. In this video, I am going to teach you how to draw an involute around circles or polygons. Okay, so what is meant by an involute? An involute is a curve traced by a point in a straight line which rolls without slipping along a circle or polygon. Okay, so now draw the involute on an equilateral triangle of side 30 mm. So draw triangle of side 30 mm, that is an equilateral triangle. So now this is equilateral triangle and these are the vertices. Now also sometimes you need to trace the centroid of this triangle. So this is you have to draw these vertical and these two lines, that is perpendicular at midpoint. So this line, that O is the centroid. Now draw a line from B equal to perimeter of the triangle. First, what you have to do, you have to know the perimeter, even if it is a circle. For a circle, the perimeter is pi d, and for a triangle, the perimeter P is equal to AB plus BC plus CA. In this case, each side is equal to 30, so you have 90 mm, that is the perimeter. Okay, next. So you have to divide also into three sides of that perimeter. Understood? Now, I have drawn this line and this S contains three parts. One side, the other side, the other side. 30, 30, 30. Okay. So mark. So I have to start from B. So now my starting point is O, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. So these are the points. Now draw lines A1 is equal to 30, C2 is equal to 60, and B3 is equal to 90, like that. But I have already drawn this B3. Okay, now this is A1. Okay, this is C2. Already B3 is drawn. Okay, so now that is the second point 2. This is the first point 1. So I have to start from A. Okay, in all my involutes of different polygons, I use A notation. First center of rotation is this one. So this A1 is equal to 30 mm. C2 is equal to 60. Like that, say B3 is equal to 90. Got it? So your journey starts from 0. So taking A as center, you have to draw one arc covering 0 and 1. So draw an arc taking A as center and radius equal to 30 mm. Okay, now that is over. Next, draw another arc taking C as center. So we move clockwise, right? A, C, B. Okay, right. So next, that is the radius I wanted to show. Now this is another arc and it will adjoin with this first arc. And like that, similarly, you can also have to draw another arc taking B as center and radius is equal to 90. Okay, see how simple it is to draw an involute on an equilateral triangle. Okay, so I hope you understood, and I move on to the other involute on other polygon. So three sides I have first taken up. Now you don't forget to subscribe if not subscribed yet, and also press the bell button to receive notifications. Now draw an involute on a square of 30 mm. So first I have to draw square ABCD. Okay, my first center of arc is A, next center of arc is B, next center of arc is C, next center of arc is D. Okay, so now I have to draw one line from D that is equal to perimeter of the square. Okay, so you can say it is DC, CB, okay, next to BA, then AD. Okay, so this is a perimeter. Now I have to start one line that is from C. I am going in this direction anticlockwise. So C will be, so if the side is 30, CD will be, this point is 60. Okay, so the total is, this is 120. 30, 30, 30, this is 120. This is 90. This is 60. This is 30. So you can start with A and then point P1, B point 2, C point 3, and D point 4. Okay. Now it is the time now to draw an arc like. So these are the radius I wanted to show. First I will join D and P1. Okay, right. First arc is over. Second arc, third arc, and fourth arc has been completed. Okay, so there is another point. So he will ask you to draw normal and tangent at any point of this involute or otherwise curve. So that I will take up in another video. Okay, so hope you understood well. Now I wanted to draw an involute on a circle of diameter 30. So you have to draw radius equal to 15. A circle has been completed, and also it is important to divide the circle into 12 parts to have more points on the curve so that we can get a smooth curve. Now this is C is the center of the circle, and this point is our starting point, that is a zero point, as we taken up in the previous cases. Okay, so these are the 1, 2, 3, 11. And what you have to draw? From the point P, you have to draw a line equal to pi d. So pi d is perimeter of the circle. Okay, so accordingly you have to divide into 12 parts. So P is 0. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 11, and then you can consider that as a 12. So like that you have to divide taking compass help. Okay, or otherwise there is a method how to divide a line into a number of equal parts. That also you can follow. Okay, that will be nice. But don't use that is a scale to divide these points. Okay, right. Now, so here we have to draw tangents at, so this PP is a tangent to this CP. Now we have to draw another tangent to, that is tangent to this line. So this can be considered as a normal. Okay, so this can be normal and that can be tangent. This is normal, this is tangent. This is normal, you have to draw another tangent. Okay. like, so names are given to these points 1, 2, 3 and PP. So we have unwound this thread or wire that is been wounded on the drum like. Okay, so you can have to think like that one. So these lines are tangents. So you have to see one thing, but while drawing this one, so you have to draw this and this tangent is 90 degrees. Here also 90, here also 90. So you have to simply mark the point, and from that you have to draw tangents, or otherwise you can say geometrically perpendicular lines. This from this line, this length is 12th of that perimeter. Okay, so that is P1. Next one is this length is P2. Next length is P3. Next length is P4, P5, P6. This in this direction. So you can simultaneously also mark the length of that tangent. So these are the tangents. Okay, so now work has been completed. Now it is our duty to draw a smooth curve adjusting between two things and then finally complete the curve. So this is, okay, so this center is also necessary for getting, and if you wanted, if you are asked to draw also normal and tangent to any curve, right? Hope you understood well, and I will like, share among your friends and also give your comment. That will boost my energy so that I can release number of videos on different topics, innumerable topics.